With us now via Zoom, we have Eli Buendia, Marcos Adoro, Raymond Marasigan, and Buddy Zabala of the Eraserheads. Good morning to you guys.
Good morning, Karen.
Good morning.
Karen. And before anything, hello. I want to personally say good morning to Eli, because among all of you, I know Eli personally. He's been to my home, I would say, I think that was 2015. But hello, Eli, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, let's start first with this. Okay, everybody is waiting for this. How long has this been in the works? I'll start with Marcos. Marcos, how long has this concert been planned?
I don't know if this is connected to the meetings we had during 2019, around November.
Okay, so before the pandemic.
Yeah, because you're going, it's the same thing. Maybe.
So is it fair to say roughly this has been in the works for 3 years, this reunion concert?
Yes. Maybe. Yeah.
Okay. Wait, I'm curious. In the group, sino sa inyo ba ang kuya? Sino ang itinuturing yung kuya sa grupo? Sino yon? Ikaw talaga. Ikaw talaga, Marcos, ang kuya. All right. Okay. So what...
Ako'y sasagot ka.
Ikaw sasagot. O sige, Marcos. Sino ang kuya?
Sino lahat? Kasi ako pinakabata.
I didn't hear that. Sino ang kuya?
I have an answer.
Ikaw.
Silang lahat kuya ko.
Ah, sila.
Kasi ako pinakabata eh.
Hang on, I have an answer.
Okay, go on. Go on, buddy.
Si Kuya Boji.
All right. Okay, yun ang kuya. Okay, all right. So yung kuya ng grupo, can you answer this? What made everybody say yes to this reunion concert? I mean, we know it wasn't easy. You all had to deal with different issues, but what made you all say yes?
Ako, personally speaking, I said yes out of morbid curiosity.
This is so you, Eli. Okay, go on.
I just wanted to see how it will turn out, you know.
Okay, so you wanted to see how it will turn out, the concert as a whole, or is it honestly how the public, if the public wanted all of you?
No, it's not that. It's how we would collaborate on this, how the band would conceptualize the show, you know, stuff like that, artistic stuff.
Yes, okay. Raymond, what about you, Raymond? Why did you say yes to the concert?
I think it was the right time, perfect timing for everybody. Everybody, usually in a given year, everybody has projects that they're busy with. I think coming out of lockdowns, everybody had, like, you know, extra free time, so I think that was one of the main things.
Okay.
Nobody's promoting an album.
Yes. So the timing as well. And what about
timing?
Yeah. What about you, buddy? What made you say yes?
I'd like to say Francis. Francis Lumen is the producer of the show.
Okay, that's good.
He asked very nicely.
Uh-oh.
And we all answered. To be truthful, Karen, there's always, I believe there's always a demand, there's always interest in the Eraserheads for performing.
Agree.
It just so happens that this year, coming from the pandemic, after a 2-year lockdown, people want to come out in droves and people want to experience the live show again. I think, like Raymond said, it's perfect timing. So thank you, Francis.
Okay. Now, that's interesting. And I wanted to say very quickly, and you can take this, buddy, how have you all evolved? I mean, I want to watch the reunion concert. But, buddy, you seem to me like, I don't know, do you now, are you still a musician? Or do you now work in an office? What's your life now?
I am glad to say that, and really grateful that I'm still a musician. I'm a working musician. I'm now with a band called Moonstar 88.
All
They've
right.
been around a while.
Uh-oh.
And it's still, I'm still doing what I love, and I'm still performing for people because that's what Filipinos want to see.
Yeah.
I'm just lucky that this year we're given the opportunity to play Eraserhead songs in okay. front of a big crowd.
Amen. All right, Raymond, I'm curious, what's your life like now?
You know, still in music and riding bikes.
Riding bikes. What about you, yes. Marcus? Yeah, Marcus, I'm curious.
I've been painting heavily every day during the pandemic. But I always wanted to do that.
Oh, so you're an artist? Is that right to say? Are you selling your art as well?
Meron akong one-man exhibit currently now. Nasa social media ko andun yung directions.
Oh, all right. Okay, but, I'm going to check that out. Now, of course, you have Ellie Buen... I'm sorry, Marcus, you were speaking?
But there's always music. You know, pipinta ako, there's always guitar. Sa tabi, like...
Okay, yes. And then, of course, Ellie Buendia, the forever cool dude for many people. So I wanted to ask you, I mean, these years when Eraserheads, when you weren't playing, what have you been up to, Ellie?
I've been busy with my record label, Offshore Music, trying to help new artists like Anna Mori and Pink Man.
Oh,
young artists. And also I've been performing also on the side.
So Ellie, moving on, is the key now is, will people get what they've always expected from Eraserheads? Or are they going to see something new? Because let's face it, we've all gotten older. You've all gotten older. You now have, some of you have kids. So you're coming from a different place, right? And it happens to most bands. What will they see, Ellie? What kind of Eraserheads will they see?
Well, hopefully they'll see what they came to see. And... much more. We are aware of what people love about the Eraserheads, even more so than 30 years ago when we did our last album. Kasi that time, hindi na tumutugma yung gusto ng banda sa gusto ng public.
Maganda yan. Teka lang, I wanna catch that. Mahalaga ba sa inyo yung gusto ng public kesa sa gusto ng banda? Kasi, I mean, you know, musicians go through this, right?
Yung
artistic creativity, ito gusto ko. Pero paano yun? Hindi yun ang gusto ng tao.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, we are more aware now being older and having, you know, the perspective of, seasoned musicians, and we have sort of a bird's eye view now of everything. We're much, like you said, much cooler.
Older, yes, so, but still cooler, cool.
We want this show to cater to everyone. Not just our fans, but also, siempre, also our own creativity.
Okay. What, buddy? Can you share also the other guys? Please share. What do you want the audience to see?
Personally, I'd like the audience to share in the singing.
Yeah,
we would love them to hear.
Okay.
Yes, we would love them to hear us. As older musicians playing our own songs, because when we recorded the music way back when, what is it, like 20, 30 years ago, we've grown older. We've changed the way we played. We were hearing things differently now. So I think the people will enjoy how we perform the songs that they know very familiar, that they're very familiar with. There's going to be a lot of visual, it's going to be a visual treat also.
Okay.
We have Direk Paolo Balich.
You mean at the back, right?
Yes.
That's how international concerts do it. I've been to one, right? Yeah. So you have that, okay.
Yes. So we have Direk Paolo Valenciano helping us pull off the show.
Okay.
We're very excited that the people catch that too. That's the part where they get to see. We're the part that they get to hear.
Yeah.
So see you there.
I'll see you there. Well, guys, I'm so sorry we don't have enough time, but I would invite you back again on the show because we just had a bit of a long conversation a while ago. But any closing statement, perhaps Marcus, Raymond, Buddy, Ellie, just quickly, can you give a closing statement for everybody watching?
Aaron, tickets are still available, first and foremost.
Yeah.
They opened up new slots for everyone from the mosh pit to bronze, and they actually have a new general admission section for so that everyone can watch.
Okay, that's good. Okay, guys.
Karen.
Yes.
We're hiring a new member as of today.
Okay, is it Chris?
We're trying to recruit somebody who can play a lot of instruments. We're going to call Maria Resta.
Okay, I'm sorry. That's a good one. I thought you were literally going to, but yeah. Considering she plays 8 instruments, right?
That's a good one. She's going to be in our band. We're recruiting her in our band. She plays more instruments than all of us.
All right. That's a good one. That's a good one. All right, guys. Well, I do hope to see you again. If you're still willing, please come back on the show before the concert starts. That's Get Start Today. Ellie, Marcus, Raymond, and Buddy, you take care, guys, and I'll see you soon.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, Karen.
Bye, guys.